Hi, I'm Jari Hakkanen. I'm senior level designer at Housemark, and today we are going to play Matterfall, new twin stick action arcade game from Housemark. Let's have an awesome playthrough here at E3. On Matterfall, you play as Avalon Darrow, a hired mercenary who's been hired to take down a red matter enemies from the Fortuna City. And now we are at the hydroponics level. This is the lots of foliage, atmospheric effects and like plants. This is the place where the oxygen is produced to the city. Basically, what you control with this game, it's a twin stick shooter. You move with the left, shoot with the right. Here we are utilizing our dash move. You can actually dash through to enemies and stun them, and then you can easily kill them. So when enemies turn blue, they are stunned and they are easier to take down. Yeah, here's this big spider. It's a bigger enemy, but easy to get down if you know what you're doing. There's a grenade that the character can shoot by pressing R2. It's an augmentation that you can get from the civilians when you save them from the levels. You can get different types of augmentations. There are a grenade, a seeker with a homing bullet, power shot with the piercing bullets, and a shotgun with the short range but a powerful blast. Here you can see those arcade enemies. They are dropping these blue orbs that if player collects those and can then activate overcharge mode. When the time slows down, player is invulnerable and has extra firepower, so enemies are super easy to take down. You get the highest score by doing that. And here we can see the blue platforms that player can create with his matter jet gun. This is really a score-centric game. Each level has a high score list that you can compete with other players. And you can get a score by killing enemies fast, and killing lots of enemies at the same time. And also you can get the score by speedrunning the level. So it's planned for both, so you can really choose your way how you want to approach the levels. So be fast, but be efficient and kill everything. Doing that, you get the highest score. Where rescuing the civilians, you get score, but you also get augmentation. So basically, those civilians that you rescue give you weapons, secondary fires, and passive augmentations that will modify your gameplay style.
Seeker.
Now we actually see here a homing weapon, or the seeker, that has a awesome purple projectiles that are flying to the enemies. So basically this is a weapon that you can fire and forget, and the bullets do their job. And here you can see our intense moments. There's lots of action, enemies coming all around, but you can clear them easily if you know what you're doing.
Grenade. Multiplier down. Multiplier down. Power shot.
We utilize lots of particles on our explosions, so important thing for us is also get the clarity right. We have lots of colors, lots of explosions, lots of stuff flying around, and we used lots of time to get the colors right, the feel right, so it's clear for player what's happening on the screen.
Overcharge.
We have multiple enemy types. What we see here are called arcade enemies. They spawn and try to attack the player. There is a hovering mine and missiles that player needs to dodge or shoot. Then we have lots of persistent enemies. Like here we can actually see the spider, jumping spider, turret, and a bigger sealed guy that you really need to utilize your strategy to take him down.
Seeker. Power shot.
We have this hydroponics, and then we have city, this clean, really clean sci-fi looking city. And then we have matter mines. This is dark and ominous compared to these other ones. We took lots of aesthetics from clean sci-fi movies. With the matter beam, you can actually create those blue platforms. You can activate elevators and take down score containers. Yeah, this is the zero G section. Like basically you are flying around 360. You can use all your moves that you use normally, like dashing and shooting. And now it's like 360 and floating. So basically you need to be really sure what you're doing now. You don't need to learn all the levels and the bullet patterns. They are easy to approach and they're easy to read what's happening on the screen. So basically, and you also have your moveset to help you to get through them. So basically there's nothing cheap with our bullet pattern. Now the level is ending, but I think we should play the boss also because the boss is awesome. This is called Autonomous Hunter Killer, so inspired by these Japanese arcade games with bosses with crazy names. So we have one here. It's this wasp-like red matter mechanical monster that you need to take down. It uses bullet barrages and red matter attacks, and it's going to spawn different kind of enemies. So this boss really utilizes your moveset, and you really need to be aware about your surroundings because it's going to spawn enemies behind you. Power shot. Bosses has their own score, so basically try to kill the boss fast as possible so you get the highest score and without taking damage so you can keep your multiplier up. In the game, we have three different bosses, and each they unique for the teams. So this is the first boss for the Fortuna City. We have basically easy, medium, and hard. And then when you finish the game with any difficulty, we unlock this insane mode where you have only one health bar, and the enemies are shooting revenge bullets, so it's going to be extra hard. The feedback from fans has been excellent. They are loving the game. We have been heard comments like it's super addictive, it looks awesome, and it's fun to play. Power shot. Now let's just kill that sucker. And now we actually can see awesome explosion. Their boss is dying. This is the Housemarque style of explosion. Yeah. That was Motherfall. I hope you enjoyed what you see. Thanks for watching. PlayStation.